Welcome to Hydraulic Press Channel. Today we are going to test, can you tenderize a steak with the hydraulic press? This has been requested many times for many years, and now we are going to try it. And I have chosen the most poorest meat, pork steak, for use on this test, since it's not very good without tenderizing. And we are going to do comparison. We are going to use the press and this tiny hammer thing, and then we are going to fry the steaks and see which is the best steak. Yes, so we are ready to go. So the steak goes there, and I have made a new shiny tool, so no nasty shit on my steak. And the first one is going to be like semi-tenderized, and then we are going to go full ape shit with the next one. Little bit more. Little bit more, it's hard to say, it's like stretches a lot. I think that's pretty good for the first one. It's pretty thin. And then we are going to go a bit more with this one. Yeah, I think this is like a last point to stop before you turn it just to like ground beef or something. And then we are going to leave one steak as it is. And then I'm going to hammer this. And we want also some flavor for our steak, so I'm going to add a couple of garlics there. Black peppers. And some salt. And then we are going to do like hydraulic press steak seasoning rub thing. I was saying that this didn't work, but it worked just fine. Yeah, and then we are going to go to kit. And we are here. And the hydraulic press rub seems to be a little bit harsh, so I'm going to put it only one steak, so we can eat actually something. This is our breakfast at the same time. Yep, so this is the regular steak. This is the hammer steak. This is the all out steak. And here is the like sensible press steak. I think these three are ready. This has to wait still some time. But let's go back to the press and do the taste test. Yes! And here we go. So this is the untenderized. This is, I have to compare. Yeah, this is the hammer. This is the sensible press. And this all out. If I would choose now one steak to eat, I would choose this probably. It looks the like best. But let's start from worst to best. So first the untreated steak with the press rub. Yeah, actually the press rub isn't so bad as it looks. Hey Anni, have a test. Yeah, and then the hammer one. I have to say that this is maybe faster to eat, but it was much drier than this one. And then first of the breast steaks. I would say that this was a bit like this, but thinner. And then the last one. I'm not sure if this is any more tender than this is, but this is in smaller pieces, so there's more surface area for seasoning and all the flavors to stick. So I would rate that this is the best one. Yeah, and my wife says that this has the best structure, and the press wrap was better than the pepper mix that I have here. So I think the press is actually a pretty good tool for your steak preparation. You can handle the steak and handle the seasoning with the same thing. And this video is sponsored by Beyond the Press. It's our second channel, and we have great video coming there tomorrow. And we have also new great merch in our merch for both channels. So go check those out and subscribe to Beyond the Press for tomorrow's video. Yeah, but that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have this pelican. Looks extremely hungry and it can eat you at any point, so we must deal with it.